Well, should we do these AEW ratings?
I guess so.
I don't know if you listened to the show yesterday or not, everybody, but I mean, I said going in, the show's not going to do a million viewers. It's not going to do a million until they're back in primetime all across the country in January. And even like early January, we don't even know because they will deal with what could potentially be an issue, which is they're no longer going to be on TNT. They're going to be on a new network, TBS. TBS is available in more homes, but I mean, it's possible unless they, you know, whatever. First couple of weeks may not be all that great, but I do expect that by mid-January, the show is regularly going to be doing in excess of 1 million viewers. I did not expect it for this show here. So the viewership came out yesterday, 948,000 viewers at a 0.31 in 18 to 49. And I saw 948 and I thought, man, it's a pretty good number. And then, of course, kablammy! Oh my God, horrible number. Show's in the mud. Oh, they got to figure out what's going on. Oh, they need to fix it all. Nobody, this is my favorite, nobody cared about Danielson and Hang. I heard it all yesterday. Listen, everybody, let's be real. Should it have done better than a 0.31? Sure. Would it have been far better for it to do a 0.4 or a 0.37? Of course. But a 0.31, it's not great, but it's not a sign that, like, the sky is falling. And the viewership, you know, I heard it all. Oh, they couldn't do it. Actually, they did do a million. During 30 minutes of the Hangman versus Danielson match, hit 1.05 million viewers for a full straight half hour. Because as pretty much, you know, we told you yesterday, whenever you do a long match on television, and this actually goes for both AEW and WWE. Do you guys remember several years ago, they did this gauntlet on Raw? And it actually was a really good match, and it went like an hour and 15 minutes. And the show did like a really good number. And then all of a sudden we had a bunch of gauntlets on all the other shows, which were never as good, because the gauntlet did numbers. Because when you have a long match on television, what happens is the people that start getting into the match, they don't shut it off till the match is over. And the show keeps gaining viewers throughout the match. And so you end up doing a very good number. The Danielson Hangman match for over a half hour on Wednesday did over 1 million viewers. Now, since they moved to 5 o'clock p.m. on the West Coast, I actually don't know if anything has broken 1 million viewers. So the idea that nobody wanted to see this match or this match was a failure or whatever, it's not true. Now, what happened was when the one-hour match ended and they went to Wardlow versus Matt Sydal, the show went straight down off the cliff. It went from 1.05 million or something like that to like 850. So they lost almost 250,000 viewers after that match ended. And then they started to build them up through the Hikaru Shida match, and then they didn't make it to a million, but they were, in, I think, the nines or whatever for the MJF match that closed the show. So arguably, if you would not have gone from a one-hour match for the championship with Danielson versus Hangman straight to Wardlow versus Matt Sydal in what was essentially a 90-second squash match, if they'd gone from that to like a Young Bucks six-man or whatever, one of their party matches, it's possible this show might actually have done over a million viewers. But that didn't happen. So that's the quarter hours. The 10-week average, which, oh, the 10-week average is 0.37. They did a 0.31. That 0.37 is three of those weeks when the show was in prime time on the West Coast. We had a 0.48, a 0.45, and a 0.37. Then the show moved to 5 o'clock p.m. on the West Coast. And from there, we're in the 0.3s, 0.33, 0.35, 0.37, 0.31, 0.31, 0.33, 0.31. So, yes, it's down from what the average would be if you look, if you compare directly to shows that aired out of primetime on the West Coast. But it's not as bad as it appears if you do the full 10-week average and you're unfairly comparing it to when Dynamite was airing in primetime on the West Coast. Is it a fantastic number? Of course not. It's not a fantastic number. Is it a horrible number where we need to make strong changes and, oh, Danielson is a heel, is a failure, Hangman is a champion, he's no... No, it's a week. A lot of people watched the match. It's okay. I feel like I need to walk... I don't need to walk anybody off the ledge because the people that are freaking out aren't on the ledge. They're just finding something to point to as what they see as a massive failure by AEW. The number's fine. And it's the holiday season. The number's not going to be great next week. It's not going to be great the week after. It might not even be good the first week on TBS. But if the number is doing a 0.25 and 800,000 viewers once they're on TBS in, you know, prime time on both coasts, then you can start to worry.
Well, it's nice of you to make excuses for them the next 2 weeks, Bryan. I mean, you're making all these excuses for them right now. I mean, how dare you? My God. They've been doing this since October with the West Coast. They've been doing this since May or whatever. Why are you making all those excuses, Bryan? This is all your fault somehow. But it's silly. You know, the match was over, well over a million for those two segments that Danielson and Paige were in there. And, you know, according to Brandon Thurston, there were not a whole lot of special things that happened with TV ratings on Wednesday either. I mean, there was no extra special spike in Housewives or whatever the shows are. It's not Housewives or The Masked Singer and whatever else, you know, shows are on. But so it was just it was a little bit of an off night, and they should have followed up. In hindsight, looking at what the numbers were, seeing how they got back up to 936,000 by the time the show went off the air for that last quarter with MJF, they should learn something from that. Okay, maybe you can't just do the interview with the Young Bucks. You need to have them in there for a match. Maybe you don't follow it up with Tay Conti and Penelope Ford. Maybe they should have went with Diva and Deeb and Sheeta a little bit earlier on. You can make all those, you know, things in hindsight, and you can question it. But overall, the number was good. The sky is not falling. And I guess if you want to use this as part of your planting a flag of standing up for WWE, knock yourself out. Literally, knock yourself out.
Back in a moment, Observer Live.
Again, maybe it's just that as a Canadian who has always had health insurance, this doesn't seem... Max, smarten up.
This is going to go to the best of right here, Lance.
Yeah.
You're being corralled away by this dog.
By a dog trying to eat my wife's boots.
Oh, man. Oh, they said they must be tasty.
Yeah, if my wife gets home and her good leather boots are chewed up, I'm dead.
You'll be chewed up next.
Yeah, I'll be living outside with the dog.
If you enjoy these videos, for just $7.99 per month, you can enjoy full-length editions of the Bryan and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, Figure Four Daily with Tom Lawler and Lance Storm, the Mad Men Podcast, Speak Now Pro Wrestling with Denise Salcedo and more, plus hundreds of archived shows, all in beautiful HD. Don't miss out. Join us today.